With this clutch hub, what's happening is, although it's releasing, there's still a little bit of tension in the between the discs, and I'm not able to get neutral. So what I thought I'd do was just to put a bit of engine oil. I put some 1050 engine oil on in between and around the clutch discs, but it's still bound because of the stickiness of the oil. So I thought I might try graphite. That's graphite there, and so far it's working really well. Like, you know, this just sort of slides out on the bolts, on the clutch hub bolts here, and that's a really good sign to me. It's very hard, well, it's hard to get them to move or slide at all, but now they're just sort of falling out, and sort of bodes pretty well for you know, there being enough free play or non-binding of the discs and being able to select neutral. So far I've brushed this this graphite powder, and graphite is just the pencil, you know, the what your pencil's made out of, what you write with, made into a powder form. And you know, I've just brushed that around the outside there, in this area here, on the bolts and on the discs. As you can see, I can hardly even get them to stay on the bolts there. They actually fall out. So I'm not really sure if this is going to work or not, but this could be a really handy tip for any YouTube viewers. That's graphite there. You get it in a plastic bottle. This is about probably, you know, it could be 10, 15 years old, still works. You get graphite at a, you know, a building outlet. Yeah, so we'll see how it goes. So I've jacked the bike up on a hydraulic lifter, because these discs, they keep on falling out.
Just a warning about graphite. Graphite contains lead. They talk about lead pencils. So this graphite will have lead in it, and lead's a poison, so you want to protect your hands. Okay, so this is the tricky bit. You want to just start these threads off. So just get the back of a hammer and create or expose some thread, and just try to thread the nut on. It's not easy to get it started, and you don't want to cross thread these nuts. If you cross thread it, you'll have to replace the entire clutch hub that's cross threaded at the moment. So that's going. Excuse me. It's a bit of a tussle. But you want to make sure these nuts aren't cross-threaded. I've got graphite on the outside of this clutch plate, so my hammer's slipping off a bit. It's cross-threaded. Here we go. Success. Get another one on. Oop. It's cross-threaded. Cross-threaded again. So you got to watch out. Cross-threaded. Cross-threaded. Okay, they're on right. Now I'm going to wind them back as far as possible while still staying on the thread. And now I just put these other springs on. Just put a bit of lubrication on these behind the nuts. Lubricate behind the nuts, because otherwise you'll wear out the locking mechanism. Because they just ride on a high point on this disc here, the nuts, and they lock in as you turn it. You may be able to see if I turn here. It sort of rides on a lobe just here. So I'll go ahead and put it in first. Pull the clutch in. You can see that seems quite good. That's the best it's felt yet. I was a bit concerned that when I was moving along in gear, that the clutch may slip, but that doesn't seem to be the case. It seems to have good binding strength when it's in gear and the clutch is out, and yet when the clutch is pulled in and it's in gear, it's got a, you know, there's no binding at all. It's got a good amount of free play. So it's looking hopeful. It's Sunday. I can't fire up the bike and put it in gear until 10 o'clock. It's 20 to 9 now, and so I'll have to wait for the acid test. So after doing that work, I still can't get neutral. So I'm going to try a few other things. I did a bit of research on the internet, and I'll just try a few adjustments and try and get neutral while the engine's running. Okay, I was able to get neutral twice, so I guess it's just improving technique. It might be okay. Yeah, so as you can see, it's sort of a little bit intermittent. It's not really reliable. I'd like to be able to get neutral a little bit easier than that. Okay, from my study on the internet, I came up with a few facts that may help with getting neutral when the engine's running. So the first one is try bringing the revs per minute up from idle. So that is, you got your foot on the selector, and you just give it a rev, and at the same time you try and get neutral. Another one is the clutch, so the clutch is just dragging on first gear, and you try and get neutral then. So to be a bit more specific, you just let the clutch out so the bike starts to move, and then you try and get neutral. So that is, hang on, I'll do this visually. Try bringing the revs up per minute. Revs moving it up, so you got your foot here, you try and get neutral, you bring your foot up, and at the same time you give it a bit of a rev, and that can release the pressure on the cogs. So you know, you got your cogs here, and that releases the pressure, and you may be able to get neutral that way. So the clutch is dragging,
So here's your clutch, and you got your foot, you bring your foot up trying to get neutral, and you just let the clutch out so the bike starts to move forward, and you try and get neutral then. The shifter pole adjustment, I think that's the same, I'm not sure, but I think that's the same as the nut thread depth on clutch plate tension on the disc. So that would be the adjustment of that nut there that connects to the push rod coming across from the gearbox. This is my favourite for getting neutral while the engine's running. Tighten the clutch cable. They're saying that this treble here, I've got that much before it starts to give. So they're saying there should be no treble there at all, no neutral treble. It should start bringing the clutch out as soon as you start moving this clutch handle. This one, raise the revs, slowly release the clutch till it just starts, to move the bike forward. That's the same, that's got to be the same as so the clutch is dragging. So those two are the same. Another one here is the oil viscosity, the thickness of the oil, that if it's too thick, there'll be too much drag on the clutch. So that's one possibility, is the oil viscosity. You may want to move down to a lighter grade. On the internet, I found a good oil to use if you're having this problem is Mobile 1, full synthetic, 75 to 140. Okay, so the clutch lever adjustment, that's just there, and you've got a thread there and a nut. You undo the nut, and I'll be turning the thread out. Okay, I'm going to just turn the adjuster out until the clutch lever is tight. So you can see there, that's a little bit tighter. And just keep on bringing this out. Yeah, that's a fair amount more travel. That's much better. One way I've found to get neutral is to put it in second gear and then get neutral from there. So I'll try winding the clutch out, making the clutch a bit tighter, and it's fairly tight. There's not much. There's about 20 or 30 of millimeter of travel without the clutch working. All right, so I think I've got about the tightest I can get for clutch travel, and I'll just lock that in now.
Okay, so I'll go through the list. Try bringing the revs up from idle. Well, I've tried that. That's on the video. Clutch is dragging. I'll try that now, but I don't think it'll work. Okay, so this is, I'll be letting the clutch out so that the bike just starts to move, and I'll try and select neutral. Okay, so letting the clutch drag didn't help the bike, but something's definitely helped. I'd say that it was the clutch lever adjustment, because I'm able to get neutral when the bike's in second just by pushing it down to neutral from second. So the shifter pole adjustment, or nut thread depth on clutch plate tension disc, which is that's that one there, and there's no point in adjusting that, because I know that the clutch cable is tight, because there's not much travel on hardly any travel on the lever. Tighten clutch cable. That's been tightened. The second one down the list, zero clearance at the handle cable, is the same as tighten clutch cable. Okay, so that only leaves the oil viscosity, and I'll be trying the oil viscosity when I go for my registration check, the mechanical check. If they don't pass it and they say, you know, you've got to be able to get neutral more easy, then I'll be trying a lighter oil in the gearbox. So I'll just be checking now that I can get neutral from second gear.
Looks like that's a goer.